Wow. My dream has actually come true. When Elizabeth was diagnosed with leukemia last year, I wanted to do something so badly to help her. Abiding by her wishes, we donated flood buckets to the hurricane victims, and we called them Buckets of Love for Elizabeth. Then we created Team Elizabeth to help others on United Way's Day of Caring in Anson County. But still, I wanted to do something more, and I knew that others did too. This fall, many of us were swabbed at the bone marrow registry at the high school, and a match was found in Germany for Elizabeth to receive a cord blood transplant. I continued my prayers that her transplant would be successful and that the infections would stay away. Then it came to me in a dream one night. It would be called A Song of Hope, and we would have musicians from all over the county to come to my church to sing and play instruments and show Elizabeth how much she is loved and cared for and prayed for by everyone in the community. This is it. I would like to thank everyone who helped to make this event possible, especially Patsy Brazington and Bonnie Morgan, who helped me to plan this awesome event. We are all here today to support Elizabeth and her family. And since Elizabeth and Margaret could not be here in person, we are videotaping this concert for them to watch later. But I want to show them right now how many of you are here. So, smile. She just texted me, by the way, and said thank you before she even gets this picture. One, two. And you feel free to take more pictures with your cell phone, too.
I already have.
We are so glad that you are here, and we know that you are wanting to hear the latest update on how Elizabeth is doing. So I've asked her sister, Caroline, to speak to us now.
My plan was to keep this short and sweet so I wouldn't cry, but since that's been blown out of the water, by seeing how you guys here, I'm just gonna do my best to get through it. Elizabeth is about two-thirds of the way finished with her transplant journey portion in the hospital. We are super excited by the fact that she's grafting, which means that the transplant is successful and is doing what it's supposed to. She is at the most difficult part of her journey, but the prayers and the cards and the love you guys have shown have made it a lot easier. From the bottom of my heart, I want to thank you all for being here. I want to thank you for the prayers and the love. You don't know how much Facebook messages, emails, cards, text messages mean to our family while we're going through this, and especially while they're isolated from their friends and family. So I just, from the bottom of my heart, I'm just so thankful, and this is a huge crowd. I just can't even believe it. So thank you, and I would look forward to the show.
And now we present A Song of Hope.
People can say a lot of things about Wadesboro, Ansonville, Polkton, Morven, Leesville, Peachland, Cason's Old Field, Sugartown, whatever you want to call it. But from the looks of this sanctuary today, almost filled to capacity, Anson County is a pretty good place to be, isn't it? Several people are participating in a Facebook thing called the 28 Days of Thankfulness. And I chose for mine on the 16th day of thankfulness to be thankful for music. And I'd like to share with you what I chose to put at the end of my status on Facebook that day. Bach gave us God's word. Mozart gave us God's laughter. Beethoven gave us God's fire, and God gave us music that we might pray without words. What a wonderful way for us to gather today in music. First United Methodist Church is blessed with a congregation who loves music. Many of those music lovers are in several music groups. The handbell choir members seem to enjoy Wednesday night practices almost as much as sharing their talents with others. The First United Methodist Church handbell choir will play today "Praise to the Lord the Almighty" with organ accompaniment played by Charles Leidecker and directed by Gail Leidecker.
Thank you.
Not being a native Ansonian, it was Harvey Levitt's job to introduce me to the community. And he did so by first asking me if I would join the chancel choir here at First United Methodist Church to sing during their bicentennial celebration, I believe it was. And we did a Easter cantata, the seven last words. Young Emily Leidecker, she was just a wee toddler back then. I'm telling my age, not only Charles and Gail's age at that point, but and I had been introduced to the community and to, with Harvey's friends up here at the church, and Charles and Gail both said to Emily, said, "Emily, do you know who that man is with Harvey tonight?" And she said, "Yes, that's John Jacob Jingleheimer Schmidt." So we start a choir rehearsal that night, Charles playing John Jacob Jingleheimer Schmidt as we process down the aisle practicing for that cantata. But this evening, that young Emily Leidecker Privet now, the Anson Singers, is a choir comprised of members from many different churches and communities. They began in the spring of 2011 and meet every Tuesday night at First United Methodist Church. The Anson Singers have two or more concerts a year. They have been asked again this year to be the prelude to the Wadesboro Tour of Homes on December the 8th. They are directed by Emily Leidecker Privet and accompanied by her father, Charles Leidecker. Today they will be performing He Never Failed Me Yet with soloist Mary Lynn and Mike Relton. Thank you.
can do. He delivered Daniel. I know he will deliver you.
Trust and never doubt. Jesus will surely bring you out. He never failed me yet. I will sing of God's mercy. Every day, every hour, he gives me power. I will sing and give thanks to thee for all the dangers, toils, and snares that he has brought me out. He is my God.
Wow, what a great job. And I bet Emily would love to see many of you to join them on their rehearsals on Tuesday nights, right? Mm-hmm. Okay, so y'all heard that. So, there has been much excitement getting ready for this special concert, but none can match Team Elizabeth's Children's Choir. This group originated from Thursday's Child Community Children's Choir, children from Circles of Hope, children from First Baptist Church on Lee Avenue, and children from the pre-kindergarten classes at Open Door Center for Children. One pre-K class is taught by Elizabeth's mother, Margaret Goins. These children are led by Gail Leidecker, and they will be singing a special song to Elizabeth this afternoon called On the Day You Were Born.
Thank you.
has 9 dedicated members who play across 3+ octaves of bells and chimes. The bronze handbells are manufactured by Malmark Incorporated in Pennsylvania. The polymer handles are black and white, corresponding to the keys of the piano, which is a plus for the keyboard players in the choir. The aluminum choir chimes are made by Suzuki in Japan. The choir will play 2 short pieces entitled "Morning Has Broken" by Linda Lamb and "Leaning on the Everlasting Arms" by Sandra Ethan. In the first piece, they will be using a technique called singing bell. The musician creates a beautiful sound by rubbing a wooden dowel around the rim of the handbell. The hardwood bell dowels were made for the choir by Emmett Patterson. Let's do the math. There were 9 bell ringers and 1 director, so that makes 10. So I think the Presbyterian Handbell Choir could be called the 10 Southern Bells. How was that?
That was pretty good.
Thank you. James Hodges from Lisville, North Carolina, is a self-taught guitar player. James has been playing since he was about 12 years old. Carson Williams is 10 years old and is the son of Kenny and Sammy Williams of Wadesboro. Carson began guitar lessons from James in September of this year. Carson also plays the piano. Both are active members of Gum Springs Baptist Church in Lisville. Today they will be playing for us, I Will Rise.
I wasn't going to play today. Carson's going to play. There's a peace I've come to know. Though my heart and flesh may fail, there's an anchor for my soul. I can say it is well. Jesus has overcome, and the grave is overwhelmed. The victory is won. He is risen from the dead, and I will rise when he calls my name. No more sorrow, no more pain. I will rise on eagle's wings before my God, fall on my knees and rise. I will rise. There's a day that's drawing near, when this darkness breaks to light, and the shadows disappear, and my faith shall be my eyes. Jesus has overcome, and the grave is overwhelmed. The victory is won. He is risen from the dead, and I will rise when he calls my name. No more sorrow, no more pain. I will rise on eagle's wings before my God, fall on my knees and rise. I will rise. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your glorious name. You give and take away. You give and take away. My heart would choose to say, Lord, blessed be your name. And I will rise when he calls my name. No more sorrow, no more pain. I will rise on eagle's wings before my God, fall on my knees and rise. I will rise.
Jasmine Lloyd is originally from London and has lived in Anson County for the past 10 years. She is a member of Lee Park Baptist Church in Monroe and works for the City of Charlotte. Jasmine attended South Piedmont Community College with Elizabeth, where they served together on the Student Government Association. She is singing for us today, We Are, by Carrie Jobe.
Thank you.
every shame, every fear, and every pain. Live inside the dark, but that's not who we are. We are children of the day. So wake up, sleeper, lift your head. We were meant for more than this. Fight the shadows, conquer death. Make the most of the time we have left. We are the light of the world. We are the city on a hill. We are the light of the world. We gotta, we gotta, we gotta let the light shine. We are the light of the world. We are the city on a hill. We are the light of the world. We gotta, we gotta, we gotta let the light shine. Let the light shine, yeah. We are called to spread the news. Tell the world the simple truth, that Jesus came to save, just freedom in his name. So let his love break through. We are the light of the world. We are the city on the hill. We are the light of the world. We gotta, we gotta, we gotta let the light shine. We are the light of the world. We are the city on the hill. We are the light of the world. We gotta, we gotta, we gotta let the light shine. We are the light, we are the light, we are the light. So let your light shine brighter. We are the light, we are the light, we are the light. Jesus, you are the light, you are the light, you are the light.
I believe it is evident today that Anson County, we are the light of the world today for the Goinses today. We are fortunate enough today to have Sylvia McClendon with us as well. She will be accompanied by Willie Crawford. She has been pastoring Lindsay Chapel Friendship Church of God for 9 years. And the song she will share with us today is "There Is Power in the Name of Jesus."
Over the audience, I must admit, I am Pentecostal. I'm not used to the quietness. There is power. Jesus.
To Sylvia McClendon, and all of God's people said, Amen. We all struggle. I'm next, and I'm not going to introduce myself. We all struggle, I'm sure, to wonder and try to figure out what our purpose in life might be. And do we make a difference in people's lives? Sure we do. We all meet people at different places in their lives, going through different things. Regardless of our station in life, regardless of what goes on, you do not know what you mean to each other. But one day we'll know whenever we stand before the judge and he says to us, well done. You did what I asked you to do. You were the person I asked you to be. You were the light to the world that I asked you to be. This song is simply entitled Faces, and you will never know who you've touched and what difference you've made in somebody's life until he tells you that one day about the faces of the people whose lives you've touched. You are the faces today that have touched the lives of those three Goins girls that we all love so good. And why we're here today to celebrate and support them. I dreamed my life was done, and I stood before God's Son. It was time to see what my reward would be. With love, he reviewed my life to count what was done for Christ. Cause that is what would last
eternally. See, I've done my best to share that Jesus really cares, and He would save if they would just believe. But seldom did harvest come, so few did I see one. Until the Lord said, turn around and see. Then He showed me the faces of the ones who'd come because of me. So many faces that my life had faithful to plow the field, and other times you helped me plant the seed. No matter how small the task, you did just as I asked, and thanks to you, these souls have been set free. Then He showed me the faces of the ones who'd come because of me. So many faces that my life had led to Calvary. For all those years I thought nobody saw, as I labored in lonely places, that's when Jesus smiled and showed me all the faces. For all those years you thought nobody saw, as you labored in lonely places, one day He'll smile and show you all the faces. The faces. You'll see their
Matthew Bailey, born and raised in Anson County, started learning music at the young age of 6. He studied piano under Myrtle Yandel and Gail Lydica. He is an alumni of the Anson Show Choir, music director of Ansonville Baptist Church, and currently attending Pfeiffer University, majoring in elementary education with a minor in music. Today he will be playing for us Wonderful, Merciful Savior. here tonight, I understand, and I was told that I better announce that they have revival tomorrow night and Tuesday night at 7 o'clock with Neil Hatfield. I did what I was told to do. You tell the preacher, okay? Carson Hill from Ansonville is a musician in every sense of the word. She writes her own music and can play the guitar, upright bass, mandolin, and the piano. She taught herself how to play the guitar at the age of 11. She has performed at the Bluebird Cafe in Nashville and at the Feld Motorsports Monster Jam. Carson loves making music and memories that touch lives. Today she will be performing for us, Just a Closer Walk.
Say, Elizabeth, we really love you, and we hope you get better soon, and we're praying for you. And I know some of you guys know this song, so sing along with me, because I don't want to be the only one singing.
I am weak, but thou art strong. Jesus, heal me from all wrong. Closer walk with thee. Grant it, Jesus, if I please. Daily walking close to thee. Let it be, dear Lord, let it be. Through this world of tolls and sin. Dear Lord, who cares? Who with me my burden share? None but thee, dear Lord, none but thee. Just a closer walk with thee. Grant it, Jesus, if I please. Just a closer walk with thee. Grant it, Jesus, if I please. Daily walking close to thee. Let it be, dear Lord, let it be. Let it be, dear Lord.
Anson County Show Choir alumni is comprised of many different individuals who have enjoyed performing with Anson Show Choir in their high school days. These folks come back together to relive the memories they have, and today's performance is in honor of Elizabeth, also a Show Choir alumni. Show Choir is a family, and this song is to say, we will always be there for each other. Anson Show Choir started under the direction of Charles and Gail Leidecker and Janet Kendall in 1992. The show choir will be singing Will You Be There by Michael Jackson. Elliot and his son Wade Elliot are both from Wadesboro. Lawrence is a well-known soloist and will be accompanied on the piano by his son. They will be sharing with us today a song entitled A Better Day.
Thank you. there will be a better day, a better day, ooh, child, there'll be a better day. Troubles in for a lifetime of smiles.
I forget how hard it's been to run these last few miles.
And when Jesus says to me, "Welcome home, my child," all the bitter heartache here will surely be worthwhile.
Lord, I pray for
Wow. Robert Clark is a soloist from Lisville. He used to be from Wadesboro until he married a Lisville girl. He is a member of Gum Springs Baptist Church, and he will be sharing with us today, "I Can't Even Walk."
People I ever sung in front of. Y'all pray for me. I thought number one would surely be me. I thought I would be what I wanted to be. I thought I would build on life's sinking sand, but I can't even walk without Him holding my hand. I thought that I could do a lot on my own. I thought I could make it all alone. I thought of myself as a mighty big man, but I can't even walk without Him holding my hand. Lord, I can't even walk without You holding my own. From now on, when I'm in trouble, on Him I'll call. If I don't trust Him, I'd be less than a man, because I can't even walk without Him holding my hand. Lord, I can't even walk without You holding my hand. The mountain's too high and the valley's too wide. Down on my knees, I learn to stand, because I can't even walk without You holding my hand.
think you did a pretty fine job singing in front of this big crowd. Gina Clark, and that's Clark with an E on the end, not confused with Robert Clark without the E on the end, is also a soloist from Lisville. Today she is accompanied by Allison Cameron on the guitar, and they will be performing Worn.
This song is very, very, very special to me, so I wanted to sing it for Elizabeth today, because there are times when we question what God is doing, and we will question in the deepest valleys, but he can always bring us to through the other side. But right now I can just about bet that this song is Elizabeth's heart cry, but God always brings things to our glory, to his glory.
I'm tired, I'm worn, my heart is heavy from the work it takes to keep on breathing. I've made mistakes, I've let my hope fail, my soul is crushed by the weight of this world, but I know that I cry out with all that I have left. Let me see redemption's win. Let me know the struggle is that you can mend a heart that's frail and torn. I wanna know a song to rise from the ashes of a broken life, and all that's dead inside can be.
The Red Hill Quartet. I bet you can't guess where they're from. My notes say Red Hill Baptist Church. How about that? They will perform for us this afternoon, and I bet it's the great getting up morning.
We're going to change that.
Okay, they're going to change that. Okay. Okay, so they... They're going to change their number. They have our permission to do that.
sacred throng we at his feet may fall. We'll join the everlasting song and crown him Lord of all. Hallelujah, find the glory. Hallelujah, amen. Hallelujah, find the glory. Revive us again. Son of thy love, for Jesus who died and is now gone above. Hallelujah, find the glory. Hallelujah, amen. Hallelujah, find the glory. Revive us again. Revive us again. Fill his heart with thy love. May his soul be rekindled with fire from above. Hallelujah, find the glory. Hallelujah, amen. Hallelujah, find the glory.
Those red Hillians did a pretty good job, don't y'all think? And I think because they had the right to change in the concert, I do too. I got permission from Ms. Leidecker, since she is still a school teacher. She told me I could do this. So we've taken pictures in the very beginning already, and we've got that for the girls. So what I think we should do now before the last number is if everyone would stand and turn and face the balcony, we're going to all wave, blow kisses, and tell the girls that we love them, and then you are going to sit down in an orderly manner for the last number, okay? Okay, one, two, three, we're going to wave, and we're going to love. We're going to blow kisses and all that good stuff. Somebody blow kisses. Okay. Okay, you may be seated in an orderly manner. Thank you for your continued cooperation. Has this not been a lovely evening? We owe a great big thank you to the committee, Krista Harold, Bonnie Morgan, and Patsy Brazington, and all of those who have helped put this wonderful event, this song of hope, this wonderful feeling of love and expression right here in Anson County. People can say what they want to about y'all, but I love you. It's a wonderful place to be. And I don't really care what they say about me either. I'm glad to be here too. So, but thank you all for being here. I know Krista's gonna come back and have some closing remarks. But our final performance of the day is by Charles and Gail Leidecker. They are no strangers to us. Charles is the organist and music director right here at First United Methodist Church, and Gail is the assistant music director. You can take that for what that's worth. Gail is also the music teacher at Wadesboro Primary School, and she is also the children's choir director and music director at First Baptist Church, Wadesboro. Let me put a plug in for that. And they will end our program today by sharing with us Lord of the Dance on piano and organ.
Thank you.
I'll say it again. Wow. Elizabeth, this was all for you. And we just want to say we love you and that we are praying for you every single day and that you will get out of Duke Hospital soon and we'll be back in Anson County and we'll be at the next concert that we have at this church. Our prayers, our blessings are with you. I found a blessing on my calendar today and it just fit just perfect for today. Look for the silver lining around any dark cloud, and you will see a circle of angels reflecting rays of hope and circles of joy. May you see those angels around you right now. As we end this special day, I know Elizabeth would say, share the love. I invite you all to sign one of the posters that's in the narthex. These posters will be taken to the apartment that Margaret and Elizabeth will be staying in so that she can see that you were here. And also we'd like for you to share some refreshments with us upstairs in the fellowship hall. Thank you so much, and here's the big number. Today, not including the checks and the money that has come in before the concert, but just today at this concert, y'all right there, raised $7,894.
As I close in prayer, I want to share with you a real quick story. Sitting around the meal table one day, I looked at one of my sons and I said, Bradley, you look just like your mother, but you act like me. I looked at my other son and said, you know, Brandon, you look like your daddy, but you act like your mother. And to my third child, I said, Barrett, I'm not sure who you look like or who you act like. And he says, I act like Jesus. Today, as I look at Wadesboro, you act like Jesus. Lord, go with us. May all of us act like Jesus. And Lord, we send our prayers and our blessings to Elizabeth because we love her and we know that you love her. And we know that she acts like Jesus too. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.